I have to say, when John and EJ asked me to do this, and they told me it was the show was called Access Granted, and everything, my first reaction was, why me? Because that I've never felt like I've lacked access. And then when they explained, you know, EJ wanted me to do a set based on the last about 19 months of my life, and that's what I'm going to do. But then I realized to get into that, I wanted to tell you a story from further back. Story about a time when I told a friend of mine that I perform poetry. He said that all poets spew angst, overgrown emo kids ranting about the perceived failings in their lives. I told him he was right, and that we have banded together to form a new superhero team, the Unhappy Angst Men. We fight crime, but we don't feel good about it. No angst for me, I said. I write poems about art and music and books and love and suicide and child abuse. Because sometimes writing happy is a lie. Sometimes putting out a brave face with your mouth pulled up and a rictus grin only serves to deepen the pits. As shovelfuls of dirt are dumped on your face as you close your eyes and wait for it to be over. Is that angst? Maybe. But is the world better served by a Tom Sawyer whitewash or the screaming news headline graffiti that reminds us that just because she was smiling doesn't mean June Cleaver was happy? As the world tightens a rubber tube tourniquet around its forearm, we remember that there's no difference between track marks and highways when the end of the line doesn't hold salvation. Lumping the kid with a hollow realization of mediocrity, in with those who see rebellion as a fashion statement and think that a $40 haircut will make them seem more street. Putting rips in a new pair of jeans in order to fit in with those who would trade any amount of street for a new pair of jeans or a bite to eat. Not that they would admit it, because neediness equals weakness. Vulnerability equals weakness. Depression is some sort of personality fault. But try telling that to the kid who wonders how many pills on the table. Or the woman who sees the center line as the perfect opportunity to turn the wheel and face the headlights of that oncoming truck. If it's wrong to let the darkness out, to stop it from gnawing at your insides until you're as hollow as you feel, then how do you fight the despair? Because sometimes the world just fucking sucks. And the opposite of depression isn't joy, it's indifference. Because caring cuts both ways. So give the emo kids their stupid haircuts and whiny music if that's what gets them through the day. And if you're having trouble holding on, tell me. I'll listen. Because detachment doesn't make you cool. Stoicism doesn't equal strength, and suffering in solitude is never nobler than healing together. And to my friend who said that all poets spew angst, I'll wear that mantle of pride. Because what you call angst, I call giving a shit. And I'll defend that until the day I die.